Seltzer and Ride Home and the Pepsi-Cola Bottling Company, in association with International World Wrestling, presents another exciting week of championship wrestling.
Welcome, wrestling fans, to another exciting week of international championship wrestling. We'll be seeing Larry Winters against Brian Walsh this week. Should be a super, super match. Lord Herculon will be on hand. Playboy Buddy Rose, Corporal Terry Daniels, the heartthrob Austin Idol, and of course, the man with the heart punch, Ox Baker. All this and more right after this message. Wrestling fans, as you know, if you've been watching ESPN or all your local wrestling stations, the $100,000 ICW-AWA Wrestling Spectacular Battle Royal is coming to Lawrence, Mass. On Wednesday, October 29th. Tickets are on sale now. Don't forget the date, Wednesday, October 29th, the $100,000 over-the-top 20-man Battle Royal. That's at the John P. Kane School, Lawrence, Mass. For a night of exciting wrestling, be there.
Lots of Chevy cars. Cavaliers. Check them out. Now, your main Chevy dealers coming at you with some pretty hot stuff. Like the Cavalier, best-selling Chevy in America. A look that heats up the road at a nice, cool price. Come into your main Chevy dealers and get what's coming to you.
Share the spirit with Channel 13.
Come share the thrill of good times together.
Share the joy we're giving you our best. Share the tears and laughter, excitement in the air.
Share the loving,
caring,
laughing,
caring.
Share the spirit with GME.
Confused about your recreation? Well, don't be. Come to the first annual Four Seasons All-Season Sports Show at the Portland Expo Friday, October 17th through Sunday, October 19th. Skiing, snowmobiling, snowshoeing, fishing, boating, camping, backpacking too. Travel and ATVs. More than 150 exhibit booths and seminars, demonstrations and movies too. Come to the first annual Four Seasons Sports Show, Portland Expo, October 17th through the 19th. Co-hosted by WIGY, Pepsi, and Calvin Cooler. The first annual Four Seasons Sports Show, Portland Expo, October 17th through the 19th.
With Brian Walsh against Larry Winters, this should be one heck of an exciting match.
We're back, and I've asked Austin Idol to join us. And Austin, a great win earlier in the program for you and Joe Savoldi.
Well, thank you very much, Les. You know, Joe and I are kind of a newly formed team. There's some things that already that I can see are starting to shroud this area. And I overheard over a television monitor in my own dressing room the promoter speaking with Kevin Sullivan, Mark Lewin, and whoever the girl is. I don't know who she is, but apparently...
The Angel, right?
Angel. Apparently he doesn't... Angelo does not want them in this area. I understand him. I agree with him. And if there's anything in his power to keep them out of this area, like so many other promoters, not only in the United States, but in the entire world, want to do and are doing, I just want him to know that I'm right behind him, and I totally agree with him 100%, Les.
Great, Austin. We want to talk to you further. We've got three more matches. Please stay with us. Add your expertise, and without further ado, let's go to Steve Budd, our ring announcer, for the next contest.
Here is the lottery.
out against the Irishman, Brian Walsh, and two fine young athletes, Austin. It should be quite a contest.
Well, there's no question about it, you know, and I've watched this Brian Walsh for a period of time, and he's an incredible athlete. I know that he's not that well seasoned, Les, but we'll note, and I'm sure the wrestling fans in the viewing area will be able to note, that this man is tremendously agile. He's in top physical condition, and there's something that we have in common. He's Irish, and I'm Irish-American, as you well know, Les. My parents were born in Ireland, and of course, I was born and raised here in the United States, but I'm still Irish-American, and I'm very proud of it.
Well, my Irish heritage makes me also know that there's something that comes with that heritage. Red-hot temper, right?
Well, certainly, you know, and, you know, I think no matter what, these guys are really moving in high speed. Beautiful dropkick that hit him from behind with good pass. That's something you don't see that often.
Really, you know, as you say, Brian Walsh is not the biggest man in the sport. He's growing, he's a young man, but he has so much agility, so much talent. I think he's going a long way, Austin.
Yes, he is. I mean, he's I've noticed in some of the different areas that he's well liked, and then in some of the places he's not that popular, but you have to give him credit. He's a tremendous athlete. And Les, I'd like to very briefly, I'm not trying to take away from this wrestling match, but I'd like to very briefly reiterate about what is happening in this area. You know, I've been speaking with the promoters in the entire area, and it's incredible that some of the names they have dropped on me that I know that you're aware of, such as Bruiser Brody, King Kong Bruiser Brody, who's coming to the area. A big Black Jack Mulligan, 300 and how much less?
Right, 325, 330, something like a big man.
6'7", 6'8", right?
Right. And you know what I'd like to interject here, and while you're here, I of course want to get into this a bit, is this Kevin Sullivan purple. Hey, oh, good move by Larry Winters.
Yeah, he took a real hard knock there.
Walsh was ahead of him, and Winters, of course, slowing Walsh down and giving himself a chance for a little breather here. Goes right out after his man. You know, as you're saying, a lot of competition. The competition is already tough in the ICW. It's going to get a lot tougher with the innovation of these men. Kamala, Kendall Windham. I understand that Gary Hart, one of the foremost managers of professional wrestling, may be headed to the ICW and may become the personal manager to two men that you were just mentioning. Purple Haze, Sullivan and the Haze.
Well, I understand that, too. You know, in the world of wrestling, talk grows very rapidly, Les. The grapevine is not that long. And you hear things very quickly if you're astute enough to pick up on them and pay attention. And I understand the same thing that you're talking about, that Gary Hart may be the man to come in and to advise and kind of lead the brigade of the Hayes and Kevin Sullivan, who I totally disagree with in everything that they stand for, Les. I guess it just kind of goes back to the old days of, you know, let's face it, the biblical days of good and evil. These people, they have no respect for anything, whether it's themselves or their country or their families. Or there's nothing that they seem to respect at all. And, you know, if they are going to chastise me, Les, Austin Otto or my partner, Joe Savoli, for getting on our hands and knees every night before we go to bed and say our prayers. And, hey, listen, Les, I'm a Christian and I'm proud of it. And if that goes against their grain, then so be it. But it always happens in the past, in history, somewhere or another, that good has somewhere or another come to the top. So I'm hoping in this case that'll stand true also.
You know, I had mentioned during their match to the fans that Sullivan and Lewin created controversy wherever they went, and there wasn't already some. And their first live appearance here on our program came right down here and went right to the core, to the promoter, and said they had no use for him, and they were going to try to eliminate his son, you, and anyone else that stood in the way. And, of course, let's back up and say this. Sullivan and the Hayes are a tough combination. They're not all talk. They certainly have produced more times than not, and they're going to be a force to be reckoned with, unless, like you say, they have been barred in many areas, many parts of the world, and in fact, maybe Angelo Savoldi will bar them here if they keep repeating what we saw here today.
Well, I'm sure that he's got to be thinking about that now. There's just something that's just unclean there. There's something that's not normal. There's something that goes against the grain of life, you know, and I don't want anything to do with it, Les. I don't want to be around it. I don't want my family to be around it. I don't want my friends. I don't want any wrestling fans in this area to have to contend with that. And I'm hoping. And it's not that I'm afraid of them, Les. Don't get me wrong. I'm not afraid of them or anybody else. But I hope that Mr. Savoldi makes the right decision, and that, the board of directors will make the decision not to allow them to continue to perform in this area.
A shoulder breaker by Larry Winters may have right. Oh, Walsh gets the leg over the bottom rope. These two young competitors are battling hard and fast here. Winters right now with the upper hand. And of course, Austin, when you've got two speedy competitors like this, it's just the action is so fast-paced, it's almost hard. They never lock into anything. It's go, go, go. One trying to blow up the other one, so to speak.
Exactly. It's just a matter of, who's in the best condition, who can withstand the most punishment, and that's going to be your winner, best defense is a good offense, and these two guys are definitely offensive wrestlers. I have seen virtually no defense here. They're both just taking it to each other.
Exactly. They started clashing from the opening bell, and they've been going at it ever since. Well, let me reiterate once again that I know we're talking about suspensions here in terms of Sullivan and the Hayes, but I'll say, maybe a little stronger than you would say yourself, but I've never seen Austin Idol back up from anybody of any size or any talent in a wrestling ring, and I know you would just assume soon, personally and physically, put an end to their reign in the ICW as to have Angelo Savoldi tear up their contracts and suspend them.
Well, if need be, and if I could help in any way, I mean, I'm certainly willing to. I'm not trying to sound macho less. There's an old saying, no matter how bad you are, there's always someone better. There's some of you don't see that often. Less. Someone's got to be hurt there.
Really? In the course of the airplane spin, it's Winters and Walsh both over that top rope and hitting the arena floor both days, and they could both be counted out here, Austin.
It wouldn't surprise me. That was a tremendous drop from the top rope to the floor.
It certainly was. And there it was. Neither man beat the 10 count. So it is Brian Walsh and Larry Winters both counted out on the floor of our arena. And this match will be called a draw between Walsh and Winters. And of course, Austin, with that fast pace, something like this could come up so suddenly. Both men moving so fast. Look at it here on our instant replay as we see him go for that. Almost lost him as he picked him up.
I thought he was going to airplane spinning. It looks like that's what he tried to go into, Les.
And as he's spinning, he lost it. It's Winters grabbing the rope, Austin.
Well, that was a smart move on Winters' part.
Yes, it was. And as his momentum carried him over, it carried Walsh right with him.
And Les, Winters actually sacrificed himself to prevent from being put in that airplane spin and realizing that he could possibly be seriously injured by going over the top rope backwards.
Absolutely. And cost himself the match, preventing Brian Walsh. But the Irishman, we're talking about tempers, he wants to do some more.
Go, brother. Go, brother. My parents were born and raised in Cock Coordinator, Ireland. Go, I'm with you.
You say Winters sacrificed himself. He may have to sacrifice himself again if he doesn't clear that ring.
I meant to say Corey Cockney, by the way. I'm sorry. But I love to see that Irish temper flare up. I can relate to that, Les.
The match is over, and it is a draw, but great fast-paced action like you're going to see more of here in just a few moments.
Hi, everybody. Steve Budd for International Championship Wrestling. If you've ever thought about becoming a promoter, a manager, or a referee, ICW will be happy to talk to you. Just drop us a note. The address, 11 Alpine Road, Parsippany, New Jersey, and the zip code is 07054. The ICW, very happy to talk to you, so please, drop us a note. Parsippany, New Jersey, once again, 07054.
ICW AWA action returns to Lewiston, Maine at the Lewiston Armory on Tuesday, October 28th. Listen to this, wrestling fans. It's ladies' night. All ladies, one half the price. That's right, ladies, one half the price. And listen to this card. A 20-man, $100,000 over-the-top battle royal. We'll be seeing such stars as the Wild Samoan Alpha. You'll be seeing Chief Jewel Strongbow, Superfly Jimmy Snooker, the living legend Larry Zbysko, and more.
What's best for a long, cold winter? A hot new Grand Am. Pontiac 6000 or Sunbird. The 87s are here, and your main Pontiac dealers have made a special purchase of new front-wheel drive Pontiacs, all with special introductory discounts. Choose from our biggest selection ever of new Grand Am. GM's fastest-selling cars. Pontiac 6000, with even more high-tech advancements. Sunbird, more power and performance than ever. Beat the winter of 86. Save on a new front-wheel drive 87 Pontiac. Now at your main Pontiac dealers.
important medical news for sufferers of acid indigestion. Now, a new survey has revealed that doctors prefer the relief formula in Rolaids over the formula in Tums. Rolaids antacid medicine first consumes all the acid required to bring millions 100% relief, and then keeps on working to help keep your stomach trouble-free. Treat the pain and burn of excess stomach acid with serious medicine. Remember, doctors prefer the relief formula in Rolaids over the formula in Tums.
This here's Bruce Stanley. Last year, a terrible thing happened to Bruce. Andy Wyeth painted a picture of him. Now everybody in the United States recognizes Bruce. That means for the rest of his life, Bruce will have to wear the same scuzzy hat and the same shirt with the fish scales on it. If he gets a haircut or changes anything, nobody will recognize him. That's why Bruce always wears his seatbelt. If his car ever stops suddenly, he wants his face to stay just the way it was when Andy painted it.
And that weighs more than I wish to discuss as he does battle against Tom Bandy.
At 235 pounds from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, let me introduce to you Tom Bandy. The music will introduce you from parts unknown at 350 pounds, Lord Herculon. Similar to that worn by the heavy metal rock group, Quiet Riot.
That looks like heavy plastic. Pretty hard to hurt him, wouldn't it?
I'd say so. You certainly won't, a lot of cushioning around that torso, too. You're not going to pound him there all day and get to him too easy,
I don't
think.
Easily. But you know, it's amazing. It's a strange thing about really heavy people, or even some people that are relatively fat. They are strong.
You're right. You're absolutely
like
right.
Like Paul Anderson, the strongest man in the world. He looked fat, but the devil was strong. He went over to Russia, beat everybody at weightlifting.
He didn't have the physique for Mr. America, but he certainly had it to press all that weight above his head,
yes,
right?
Yes, sir. Strong. So some of these people are tremendously strong.
Tom Bandy trying to get the Herculon, but not even making a dent in the armor. Herculon throwing an elbow of his own. And he's being methodical, and I think more because he has to. With this size and ball flu, we're not going to see him burning a lot of speed out there.
No way. Big fella's really clubbing him around.
Herculon, a very basic competitor. Forearm,
very good description.
Using just his bulk, his size.
Brute strength.
To pound his opponent
down. That's it. That's it.
I'd be curious, Lou, to see if this young man can get him to the mat, exactly what the man could do down there.
I don't know. Maybe great, maybe nothing. It's tough to know. Oh, clothesline.
Herculon throwing that forearm as Bandy came off those ropes, and he hits that canvas. And so far, Tom Bandy has been unable to set up anything on this big man. He's tried pounding on him. He's tried grabbing holes on him. And thus far, Lou, he's been able to dent the man's armor.
No, he hasn't done a thing, has he? No. Couldn't even knock him down with a drop kick.
Throws a chop, but Bandy can't get to him.
Not too well. No, not too well. Too much beef on the hand.
Herculon using the mask, and I'm curious about that. I'd be wanting to talk to one of the rules committee.
I have to talk to the referee at least. That kind of a mask got to be dynamite.
Yes.
You get hit with a thing like that.
Backbreaker.
Wow.
Flying elbow.
Man, what a tremendous amount coming down. It'd be like 500 pounds hitting you.
And a three count, and without further ado, it is Lord Herculon with no frills, putting his opponent away.
Easily.
Yes, the big elbow dropped 350 pounds, crashing down on Tom Bandy. And Lord Herculon, his first appearance on International Championship Wrestling, comes up with a win.
Hi, everybody. Steve Budd for International Championship Wrestling. And if you're willing, ICW would be happy to talk to you if you'd love to get into wrestling itself. If you've got athletic ability and you'd love to get in the middle of that ring, drop us a note, a self-addressed stamped envelope. Send it to 11 Alpine Road, Parsippany, New Jersey, 07054. We'd be happy to talk to you, and best of luck. Stay in shape. We may see you in that ring sometime.
The $100,000 Battle of Royal comes to the Lewiston Armory on Tuesday, October 28th at 8 p.m. The first match begins exactly 8 o'clock. Wrestling fans, listen to this. Not only is it a $100,000 over-the-top Battle of Royal, with the winner to have the opportunity to go for the AWA Heavyweight Champion the same night, but it's also ladies' night. That's right, wrestling fans. It's the girls' night out on Tuesday, October 28th at the Lewiston Armory. All you beautiful ladies from Maine, one half price. And listen to the contestants already signed. We'll be seeing in the Battle Royal Larry Zbysko, Colonel DeBeers, the Bad Boys, Johnny Rich, the Playboy Buddy Rose, and Pretty Boy Doug Summers, the Wild Samoan Alpha, along with Big Scott Hall, Chief Jewel Strongbow, and Superfly Jimmy Snooker, plus many more. Remember the date, Tuesday, October 28th. Be there.
Heavy duty.
Michelle, what are you doing?
Checking out the 1987 Ford Ranger pickup. Dad, why do you sell them so cheap?
Because I'm a volume discount car and truck dealer.
We have a huge selection of two-wheel and four-wheel drive pickups, and they all have volume discount prices.
Heavy duty.
Of course they're heavy duty. Heavy duty. Isn't he Howdy's brother?
Get your free mask at three convenient Jolly John locations.
And I'm not jolly unless you're happy.
This week on Dare of Terror, it's the zombies of Sugar Hill. Saturday, 11:30.
Look at the Playboy, Playboy Buddy Rose.
In the ring, waiting for our next match, one fall, 15 minutes from parts unknown, at 239 pounds, the Avenging Angel. Nevada, 271 pounds, accompanied by Miss Linda, is Playboy Buddy Rose. Big Buddy Rose fan, but I think I'm partial to his financial advisor over the gamblers.
You got a lot of company here. She is a cute gal.
Yes, she is.
And I couldn't say the same for Buddy Rose.
They're built a little bit differently. I think she's better conditioned than me.
You got that right. Closer to 214 also.
Lou and I are here making jests, but nonetheless, Buddy Rose is a tough, tough gentleman right now, squaring off with the masked man, parts unknown, the Avenging Angel. Buddy Rose wanting a shot at International Heavyweight Kingpin Jumpin' Joe Zawoli. He has made no bones about it.
That seems to be the rubber match that's going to eventually have to come up. And it's really as good a match as any artful matchmaker could possibly produce. But they make themselves, and little by little, these personality clashes that people develop, like these two people, Zawoli and the Playboy, they really do draw the people.
Yes, they certainly do. And, of course, it adds a lot of interest and a lot of fire to a match.
Yes.
As we both know, a lot of times you can start off by saying hello to someone, and by 3 weeks later, you're ready to tear that man limb from limb.
Right.
As I said, it seems like a red flag drops every time Buddy Rose sees a man with a championship belt. He wants to start badgering and belittling that person.
I know. Overhead wrist lock goes to the ropes. Takes the easy way out.
And stays there long enough to chat with the fans at ringside.
Right. Do a little resting in between. Yeah.
And look here.
Uh-huh.
Talking about the International Heavyweight Champion.
All right.
Joe Zawoli walking out to ringside.
Coming over this way, that's great.
Yes, we get a chance to talk to young Joe. All right, Joe Cialoli. I see turnabout is fair play. Buddy Rose out last week to watch your match. You've come out to return the compliment this week.
Yeah, well, I believe that to study your opponent, the best thing to do is to watch him and watch how his moves are, and you can learn a lot by that and see how he conducts himself in the ring, so you know how you conduct yourself in the ring when you go up against him.
Joe, the last time I saw you wrestle, you moved so fast, but he had better study your moves. He's going to move around him pretty well.
Yeah, well, like I said earlier, he tries to say that he's 217 pounds, but we all know that's a little bit of a fib, but when he's done with me, maybe while I'm moving so fast, he might be 217 pounds.
I think he had a lot going for him. I just told Les a little while ago, I think he had the best reflex I've seen in a long, long time.
Thank
he
you
should go
much.
Far.
Thank
Joe, we have some comments from Buddy Rose.
I just keep an eye on. I just love to watch this guy. You know, I've seen wrestlers in my time. I've seen a lot of people do a lot of crazy things, but Buddy Rose has a. He's got a style or a technique, however you want to say it, that it's really not too common, you know.
No, he's different.
Yeah, he's definitely different.
Joe, last week I asked Buddy for some basic analogies on how he would handle Joe Cialoli. He said it was some kind of ultra secret, but we're talking in basics here, not giving away any battle plans, but how you're going to go in there with a guy, you're going to have to spot him 40 pounds if and when you meet him. How are you going to handle Buddy Rose or a man like him, Joe?
Well, I'm just going there, I'm going to just use hard, clean wrestling. You know, I'm going to go in there and I'm going to use my style. I'm going to use the knowledge I have and the knowledge that was passed on to me, and I'm just going to go in there and I'm going to try my 120% like I usually do.
Well, Joe, you go in there and do that. Watch yourself getting into the ring at all times.
Oh,
watch
yeah, I got
that
4 eyes on my head.
You got it.
Is playing with his opponent as he did with his opponent last week, but I think that he's going to get into a bad habit, because if he's going to meet an opponent like yourself, he's not going to be able to take that kind of time. And
I kind of think that's a psychological tactic of his, because he makes you believe that he's in a driver's seat, you know. But I think that the guy he's wrestling right now with the proper maybe a little bit better credentials or whatever. I don't know what the proper word would be, but I think anybody has a chance to professional wrestling, because anybody who enters that ring, I believe, is qualified to be a winner. I think, you know, physically and mentally. You know?
Keep that attitude.
Yeah.
I agree with you. Right now, Rose has kicked the Avenging Angel out onto the floor. And right, he's paying more attention to you over here talking to us than he is to his opponent at this point.
He better watch out for that, because that guy might just slip out behind him and put him on his back.
That could happen.
Yep, I've seen it happen.
Referee DiMaggio starts his count now.
Yep.
And again, Rose moving in to stop that count. Rose is... He is very agile for his weight, Joe. I mean, normally...
Oh, yeah, he does move around. He does move around. Like I said, anyone who enters that ring has to have a certain capability, you know, so you can't really underestimate anyone, you know. And I think people who do underestimate other wrestlers are going to be losers in the long run.
Good thinking.
Very good. Here again, this has been more a vocal match, gentlemen, I think, than it has been a physical match.
Yeah. Oh, he's just trying to be a bully here.
Rose has really dominated this fellow.
Yes. And now he's opening up. He's giving us a little flash of the Buddy Rose system here.
See, that's
he's trying to psych you out, but don't let him do that.
No.
Again, I think this display is for Joe Cialoli. I think he's wrestling up there for you now, not for anyone else.
Exactly.
That's a bad thing to do.
Wow,
that's a devastating move right there. Yeah.
There you have it. The DDT of the Las Vegas by Buddy Rose, and he wants you in the ring. He's saying he wants you in the ring.
You want me, Lou? Could I do it?
Well, he may be going, Lou.
I hope so.
Side, Buddy Rose grabbing the championship belt that was laid down on the timer's table. He's got that belt out running around the outside of the ring now. Joe Cialoli, the champion in the ring, and he's got the belt back. All right. Now
beautiful
business, right?
See the reflex that young man has?
Yes.
I mean the flash. Just flash for a second. He just messed that belt out of money. That's the way you'll wrestle him also.
Rose talking about hurting his back. I think it was a little mental breakdown opposed to a back.
Most of those chickens end up with bad backs.
Yes.
Don't let that fool you. You know that. You know what he's doing. come in with a bad bag and beat your brains out.
In his time and his place, Lou, Buddy Rose will be there.
You got that.
He's going to pick the spot, though.
You bet. You bet.
That's what's held him in such good stead over 13 years of competition. Right now, it's psych, the champion and the challenger, and one trying to psych out the other. But Joe Savoldi is showing Buddy Rose that he is willing to back up that championship belt. You see laying in the middle. Okay, he's in there. At first, I thought he was going to his fours and invite Joe down. But
right.
He,
I don't think so. He uses the crawfish to move.
His car runs in reverse as well as it does forward.
Yes.
Buddy Rose heading for the dressing room, and I think our confrontation for this week between Savoldi and Rose is over. Rose, however, did win his match.
What a fine young athlete he is.
Hello, I'm Debbie Daigle, General Manager of International Championship Wrestling. A national TV survey released recently has shown that of all sports, wrestling has the highest viewing audience. You, too, can now own a part of ICW. For the first time, franchise opportunities are available. If you want to own a part of ICW and be at the top with the nation's number one sport, write to me personally, Debbie Daigle, care of ICW, 11 Alpine Road, Parsippany, New Jersey, 07054.
Wrestling fans, as you know, if you've been watching ESPN or all your local wrestling stations, the $100,000 ICW AWA Wrestling Spectacular Battle of Royal is coming to Lawrence, Mass. On Wednesday, October 29th. Tickets are on sale now. Don't forget the date, Wednesday, October 29th, the $100,000 over-the-top 20-man Battle of Royal. That's at the John P. Kane School, Lawrence, Mass. For a night of exciting wrestling, be there. ICW AWA action returns to Lewiston, Maine at the Lewiston Armory on Tuesday, October 28th. Listen to this, wrestling fans. It's ladies' night. All ladies, one half the price. That's right, ladies, one half the price. And listen to this card. A 20-man, $100,000 over-the-top Battle of Royal. We'll be seeing such stars as the Wild Samoan Alpha. You'll be seeing Chief Jules Strongbow, Superfly Jimmy Snooker, the living legend Larry Zbyszko, and more.
If you're ready for the powerful pro-quality alternative, listen up. That's an easy-starting echo you hear. An easy-starting rugged echo you hear. And it'll make a pro out of you.
I hear you.
Take it from Dick Butkus.
Echo, heard from the start.
Available at Jordan's Lawn and Garden Center, Ocean House Road, Cape Elizabeth. And Wilson Sun Sports Center, Route 112, West Buxton.
Man's got to do what man's got to do. Goodbye, old paint.
Oh, better get Mako.
One fall, 15-minute time limit. First, entering the ring from Japan at 240 pounds, the Ninja. And his opponent, hailing from Amarillo, Texas, at 225 pounds, from the Cobra Corps, Corporal Terry Daniels. Your referee, Tony DiMaggio, one fall, 15 minutes. And as we're getting ready for action, Lou, I think this will be a good one. Of course, we've mentioned it is for the International Television Trophy here in front of us. This is the first match in the tournament.
Well, this is certainly kicking off the program very, very well because beginning with the tournament, got some real good wrestling talent here by the name of Terry Daniels. Did a good move. He's radium over.
If the fans have been watching International Championship Wrestling, they know that you and I have become very high on Terry Daniels. And I think this young man is certainly one of the stars of the very near future.
I think he has unusual possibilities to be a champion in his own right. All these people are good at martial arts, like the Ninja Man here, but Terry countered everything and did it very, very professionally.
Terry Daniels now with the armbar on the Ninja, and so far the Ninja has not created any offense. It's Daniels controlling offensively, and this is what I like about him. Lou, he's a very quiet, unassuming young man, but he goes right out there at the opening of the bell and takes command.
He certainly did. Well, he handled everything that Ninja could throw at him, and Ninja did a pretty fair job of watching him, because I'm familiar with martial arts as you are, but Terry countered it all so well that I'm really proud of him.
The Ninja with the arm bar now, and going for the nerve center up under the arm as he applies that arm bar. And of course, it makes any of the Japanese wrestlers doubly dangerous through the fact that they can combine a bit of martial arts with their catch-as-catch-can style of wrestling.
It certainly is an advantage. You got two ways to go, and that's truly a wonderful thing. And if a man is not oriented with the oriental arts, the martial arts, you can really get in trouble that way.
So much excitement at International Championship Wrestling. Of course, as we mentioned, this match is the first of the television tournament matches, and we'll be having one of those each week on television until there is a definite winner. Plus, they're going to start a tournament very soon for the prestigious championship belt, which you wore, Lou.
Yes, we want to do that, and what we're shooting for is an undisputed heavyweight champion, which we sorely need in the wrestling game. And I think it's going to be a wonderful thing, and I think International Championship Wrestling has done a wonderful job in furthering this cause, and I want to lend a beautiful move. Did you see that?
Oh, the Ninja caught him. Daniels eluded him on the return, but Ninja was waiting with that kick, and Terry is in trouble.
Caught a foot right in the kisser, didn't he? I'm telling you.
The Ninja taking command now as he pulls Daniels up, windmills that arm, and goes to the arm bar, and the Masked Man has combined his martial arts with the catch-as-catch-can wrestling.
He's pretty well-versed. He certainly is.
Daniels moving up slowly now, and of course, I want to mention that coming up in this hour, you're going to be seeing great stars like Jumping Joseph Oldie, the new International Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. He's on the card, along with...
Something else, isn't he?
Midsection shot by the Ninja. That was a good old American fist. I don't care what you call it.
Yes, I hear you. He's very handy with the feet. A lot of agility and a lot of know-how. And he really puts it in there and gets the most of impact that he can possibly get when it strikes him.
Daniels,
his opponent.
Daniel's trying to come to his feet now as the Ninja applies that pressure to the arm bar. And thus far, it's a pretty even match. It's been give and take on
Fireman Carey, right. That's an old amateur hole, Fireman Carey, you know. It's crazy, but they come in really handy.
Yes, they do. And we've mentioned so many times that Terry Daniels, having trained at Camp Slaughter under the infamous Sergeant Slaughter, certainly is a man who knows how to accept a bit of pain and hang in there with it, Luke.
That's part of the game, and if they don't understand that at a very early age, you just don't belong in there.
We're going to be having Playboy Buddy Rose on the scene later, and Playboy is raising a lot of vocal ruckus about International Heavyweight Champion Joseph Oldie. Joe had a great tour of the Northwest and has just returned with that belt, and of course the man he defeated for it is no stranger to you, Louis Dory Funk Jr.
Yes, I know, and I'm really impressed with this young man. I've taken a good look at him, watched him in his wrestling, a lot of expertise, and of course wrestling is hereditary, as we well know. His father was a great wrestler, and I wrestled him in... The Savoldis have been good wrestlers for many, many years. But this young man has really, really some strong possibilities to win like an undisputed championship.
Yes, he certainly does. And we're going to be seeing Joe in the very next match. But right now, Daniels with a scoop and the body slam on the Ninja. And Terry trying to build a head of steam and a headbutt by the young man.
You know, as easily as he picked up the Ninja and controlled him up in the air there, it tells you something about the hidden power this young man has.
He's, by today's standards and wrestlers, he's actually average at 225 pounds as far as size, but he does have a lot of power.
A lot of tendon strength there that isn't apparent, because many times big muscles doesn't have the tendon strength that this fella has.
Daniels shoots him across and hooks him with that elbow, spins him around, and down goes the Masked Man. Terry Daniels still trying to shake those cobwebs and moving in now to try and take command. And of course, as we both know, Lou, a lot of times a wrestler will move strictly on instinct. I mean, you sometimes go for minutes without knowing actually where you are, what you're doing. It's all instinct.
Having been in a gymnasium and devoting your life to it, of course, you do things inadvertently. You just go ahead and do it, because many times you start to stop to think about it, it's too late. So you must do it by reflex.
A martial arts blow to the chest by the Ninja drops Terry Daniels. And the Ninja now trying to take command, and neither man having a decided advantage as of yet. Daniels hanging in there brilliantly, Lou.
He really has, and this Ninja is really impressing me. He really knows his moves. He knows how to hold his man and injure him to the best of his ability.
Daniels hacking away at the midsection, finally breaks free, ducks the chop.
Beautiful backdrop, Greco-Roman backdrop. Beautiful.
Fantastic move, and from the jaws of defeat, Terry Daniels pulls out a victory.
The $100,000 Battle of Royal comes to the Lewiston Armory on Tuesday, October 28th at 8 p.m. The first match begins exactly 8 o'clock. Wrestling fans, listen to this. Not only is it a $100,000 over-the-top Battle of Royal, with the winner to have the opportunity to go for the AWA Heavyweight Champion the same night, but it's also ladies' night. That's right, wrestling fans. It's the girls' night out on Tuesday, October 28th at the Lewiston Armory. All you beautiful ladies from Maine, one half price. And listen to the contestants already signed. We'll be seeing in the Battle Royal Larry Zbysko, Colonel De Beers, the Bad Boys, Johnny Rich, the Playboy Buddy Rose, and Pretty Boy Doug Summers, the Wild Samoan Alpha, along with Big Scott Hall, Chief Jewel Strongbow, and Superfly Jimmy Snooker, plus many more. Remember the date, Tuesday, October 28th. Be there.
Well, come on over, baby. Whole lot of dealing going on. Your Toyota dealer has a whole lot of value going on.
Right now, dealers are rolling in the new 87s. From Toyota, the number one selling import. See the all-new Tercel. See the all-new FX16. See the new Camry and Camry wagon. See your Toyota dealer fast while he still has something to see.
Come on over, baby. Whole lot of dealing going on. Who could ask for anything more?
See your Toyota dealer.
There were choices. I chose Andover College. It got me where I wanted to go.
The American heartthrob, as he'll go in that ring against a man who has really made one heck of a name for himself from Russia, the Mad Russian. So let's go right to the ring and pick up this match.
This match, one fall, 15-minute time limit, from Russia at 233 pounds, the Mad Russian. From Las Vegas, Nevada, 240 pounds, the Universal Heartthrob. Let me introduce to you Austin Idol.
One of the most colorful wrestlers I have ever seen.
Lou, we've talked about charisma, we've talked about physical conditioning, intimidation, wrestling, and color. We've seen it all right here in one well-put-together package.
You're saying that again, baby. That's the truth. I'm really impressed with this young man.
I am, too.
I've never seen anyone work any harder at caring for his body and learning his craft than this fellow has.
He is, no doubt, flamboyant, very vocal, but he has backed it up time and time again.
Boy, doesn't he, though? I've seen him all over the world.
Formerly the National Wrestling Alliance North American Heavyweight Champion, national television title holder, and right now a man who would like to win the International Heavyweight crown and also the big television tournament. Austin Idol, the Universal Heartthrob. Of course, this is the man that Ox Baker says he's going to put into a trash can. I'll buy a ticket for that.
I want to see that, too. I'd like to see who's going to end up with the trash can or in it.
I think you were right. Maybe wearing it would be more on the case.
Right. Baker's liable to find that trash can right over his head. But this fellow, he must intimidate some of the wrestlers, or most of the wrestlers, because anyone can see that he trains and trains and trains. With a body like that, it doesn't come for free, as you know, Les. You got to work for it.
Absolutely. I've been to the gym with him. I've trained alongside the man, and he's just phenomenal.
You should know.
And when I've quit, I've sat and watched him go on for another hour, and now just pushing heavy amounts of iron. He's something else.
I hear you. Some of these people are really fanaticals in training, and that's wonderful.
Well, the Mad Russian has finally brought his match into the ring. And
also has a very, very fine body.
Yes, a good set of guns on him hanging from those shoulders.
I mean, look at that dude. Fine-looking athlete.
The bell is rung. Let's see a little action, gentlemen, as we're ready to roll.
He supposes he's in his hometown in Moscow or wherever it is. But he isn't there today, baby, because most of these people love Austin Idol.
Our referee for this event, Tom Fernini. Tom, one of the top referees around the country. You may have seen him with the AWA. And Tom has refereed for many of the top alliances and many top championship matches. Maybe the Russian thinks that Idol's going to get tired and go home.
You better think again.
Of course, don't forget, coming up, immediately following this event, we're going to see the $1,000 TV challenge match. Larry Hamilton and his partner, Ron Sexton, will be squaring off with a Hollywood blonde right here on television. Hamilton's looked for him. He's chased him. He's finally got him here. He's put up $1,000. His partner, Ron Sexton, they'll be doing battle in the very next match, our main event, on today's International Championship Wrestling. Austin Idol ready to do business now and pay a pose down.
Aha! Just start posing. Austin's got the top hand there.
He certainly does.
Looks like a power lifter, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Idol's got the cuts and the shape.
Oh, yes. That's the difference.
Collar and elbow, jockeying for position, and a little power move on the part of the masked man, Lou.
He's strong. He looks it. Looks like a powerhouse. Really put together. Both of them are.
Again, jockeying for position. And you know, okay, a little flexing by the Russian once again.
Yeah.
We watched him go to that collar and elbow, Lou, and of course, we both know that a lot of matches are won or lost right there in the initial lockup at the beginning of a match.
Oh, yes.
I've seen guys so intimidated after 2 or 3 seconds of that they're not worth a daggone for the rest of the contest.
Not so hard right out of them, right.
All right, Austin flexing those 20-inch guns.
Tough to discourage him.
Years ago, I saw Austin Idol at 280 pounds. Talk about a power lifter. He didn't have the shape, but still was in phenomenal condition.
Power lifter.
Oh,
sure.
Yes, he certainly was. But I like him at this at 240. He's got the speed to go along with that power.
Oh, yes.
Look who's here, Ox Baker, added ringside to add a little something to this one. Baker walking around with his garbage can.
Oh.
I don't know if he's got a day job or...
he's trying to distract Austin Idol's attention is what he's doing.
He's got a garbage can with a crutch in it, and of course, if you were here with us last week, you know that... He had to show videotapes of Austin Idol and said he was going to put Idol in that garbage can.
As we said earlier, you better be careful. He may be wearing it.
That's right. Here, Austin making a costly mistake, turning his back on the man
in
the ring.
You see, getting his attention. That was the ploy.
But of course, you know, with help, I think I can be as tough as Ox Baker.
That's right.
I don't have to weigh 300 pounds if we're ganging up on somebody.
That's right.
But right now, the Mad Russian, the masked man, taking advantage of the chance he was given by Ox Baker and pounds away on Austin Idol. Idol in trouble. Baker so far hasn't made any contact, but certainly has cost Idol the offense in this contest, Lou.
Idol has the adrenaline flowing now. Watch him. He's a strange character. He really is. He gets turned on. I don't know what it is. I saw him in Puerto Rico once, and he just went absolutely hog wild.
And he's going after the Mad Russian now. Look at him shooting those left jabs and looping right hand coming from left field.
He's something else. Look at the power behind it, those arms. Unbelievable.
Little right jab to the side of the head. You can see Ox Baker down in the right-hand corner of your screen. Now you see a good shot of him there. Baker yelling instructions to the masked man, but at this point, to no avail.
And
that masked man's got to weigh 250 or 60. The idol picks him up just like a feather.
Certainly did. Good body slam, Austin, to that second rope. Watch him as he flies. Elbow drop.
Wow, right into solar plexus.
Not yet, Austin says.
He won't give it to him yet. He won't let him be beaten yet.
We called the figure four. He calls it the Las Vegas leg lock.
That's concession, baby.
You don't get up from that one, brother.
Not too easily. Broken legs, maybe.
Austin Idol puts his man away. Tom Fernini calls for the bell. And by submission, it's Austin Idol, your winner over the Mad Russian with a figure four leg lock. And as we said, Austin calls it the Las Vegas leg lock.
Whatever he calls it, it's good.
It's the job done by any name, right?
Yeah, right.
Let's see what Ox in his garbage can thinks about this now.
Yeah, I think Ox will go back to the dressing room now.
The $100,000 Battle of Royal comes to the Lewiston Armory on Tuesday, October 28th at 8 p.m. The first match begins exactly 8 o'clock. Wrestling fans, listen to this. Not only is it a $100,000 over-the-top Battle of Royal, with the winner to have the opportunity to go for the AWA Heavyweight Champion the same night, but it's also Ladies' Night. That's right, wrestling fans. It's the Girls' Night Out on Tuesday, October 28th at the Lewiston Armory. All you beautiful ladies from Maine, one half price. And listen to the contestants already signed. We'll be seeing in the Battle Royal Larry Zbysko, Colonel DeBeers, the Bad Boys, Johnny Rich, the Playboy Buddy Rose, and Pretty Boy Doug Summers, the Wild Samoan Alpha, along with Big Scott Hall, Chief Jules Strongbow, and Superfly Jimmy Snooker, plus many more. Remember the date, Tuesday, October 28th. Be there.
Don't do it.
A man's got to do what a man's got to do.
Hard day.
Goodbye, old paint.
Uh-oh, better get Mako.
Mako, state-of-the-art auto painting and body repair. High-tech, low prices keep Mako on top.
If you say it, uh-oh, better get Mako.
Hello, I'm Kim Block, inviting you to join me for At Issue this Sunday, when we'll be talking about the new Crisis Intervention Hotline at Southern Maine Medical Center. It's the first of its kind in Maine because it is based in a hospital and staffed by paid professionals. Dick Sheehan, the hospital's supervisor of Crisis Intervention Services, will be joining us to explain how the hotline helps people with stress-related disorders. So please join us for At Issue this Sunday at noon.
Face. But here's the man with the heart punch, the man who has put more men out of professional wrestling than anyone in the world, Ox Baker.
At ringside with me on our mics is Austin Idol. And Austin, we almost had a confrontation during our in-depth. I know you and Joe Savoldi came out, heard the comments of Kevin Sullivan, and it's turned it very quickly into a mudslinging war already.
Well, you know, Les, I heard some of the things he said. You know, it's just like some of the things I said before. You know, the man cares about nothing. He stands for nothing that is good. And he even made comments about my mother. Well, Les, I have a comment to Kevin Sullivan. At least I knew who my mother was. I wonder if he can say that. And I'm looking at Ox Baker right now, Les, and it's just as fresh in my memory now as it was when he punched me in the heart with whatever he has taped into his fist, knocked the breath out of me. And I'm telling Ox Baker right now, although he can't hear me, Les, maybe you can relay it to him, or Angelo Savoldi, the promoter, can relay it to him. I have not forgotten about Ox Baker, and believe me, sooner or later, Ox Baker and Austin Idol are going to lie. lockup, and I plan on retribution in every way, shape, and form.
Of course, Austin, as you mentioned, you can't not forgetting with the competition stacking up in the ICW now, men like Ox Baker, Sullivan, Lewin, men of that ilk, it's tough to forget anybody. And in fact, it's tough to stop for a second thinking about each and every one, because each man is lethal, each man is a top competitor.
Well, that's true, Les. You know, and it seems like, you know, we've known each other quite some time, you know, and, you know, it seems like every area that I ever venture into, it seems like I always end up right in the middle of the hornet's nest. And since coming to this area, I can already see it start to develop again, and it happens again and again and again and again. And Sullivan and Lewin and the Angel, if they think that this is going to be any different from any other place that I have gone and wrestled, whether it was here or abroad, out of the country, it's not. Because no matter what those forces were and no matter what the numbers were, less some way or another, I always managed to survive. I'm not saying that I've never been defeated before, less. I'm not saying I'm the biggest. I know I can see the pinfall right there. He's knocked him unconscious, apparently.
The hard punch by Ox Baker, we were talking about it, and as you were talking, we saw it in action. And again, Ox Baker, with that big hard punch, comes up with a clear-cut, precise win over his opponent, Chris Galahad.
Hi, everybody. Steve Budd for International Championship Wrestling, and we just want you to know that we greatly appreciate all of the cards and letters that you send in to us. Without your support, ICW Wrestling is nothing. And please, keep sending them in. If you want to write to us, here's the address. 11 Alpine Road, Parsippany, New Jersey, and the zip code is 07054. Send those letters in, and we'll answer every one of them.
Hi, I'm Debbie Daigle, General Manager of International Championship Wrestling. High schools across the nation are faced with rising insurance costs for their athletic programs. Many schools are falling in jeopardy of canceling their programs altogether. ICW is responding to this situation by offering schools the opportunity to raise money, by co-promoting you to come to your school to raise money. Write to me personally, Debbie Daigle, International Championship Wrestling, 11 Alpine Road, Parsippany, New Jersey, 07054.
Well, that's it this week, wrestling fans, for another exciting week of International Championship Wrestling. Next week, tune us in, because what a special we have for you. We'll be seeing what in the world is going on with Phil Apollo. So you'll see it all right here next week on International Championship Wrestling.
Share the spirit with WGME TV.